Hi, my name is Dr. Daniel Cantor, and I'm only the president of the Florida Society of Neurology because I'm here with June Halper, who is the executive director of this meeting of the Consortium of MS Center, and I'm here with Dr. Jerry Walensky, who is the president of ACTRIMS. And we've talked about the different kinds of meetings. We just met with Dr. Rivera about LACTRIMS, we've been to ECTRIMS, and then we know that the ACTRIMS meeting is going on. So my question to you, as we stand here in front of the Consortium Foundation, where we raise money to try to help education of medical students, of physical therapists, etc., how do you think the consortium and the consortium meetings impact actual patients' lives back home?
Well, I'll let Dr. Walensky talk about the scientific aspects, but from the team approach to MS, which I believe is vitally important in a disease that lasts a lifetime, this meeting reinvigorates people in terms of helping them network with their colleagues. It helps them learn new techniques and skills in managing patient problems, and it allows them an opportunity to share information with their colleagues so that they can network and communicate together throughout the year. And then we have our partner, ACTRIMS, that can provide us with...
Well, ACTRIMS for 17 years now has been putting on educational programs with the idea of helping physicians and other health professionals that are interested in multiple sclerosis be informed. So that's first and foremost what we're about. But there's also another component to that, and this meeting tends to be a very good forum for it, because what we like to do is to be able to have a place where young people can come, have the opportunity to present their work in a forum where it can be constructively appreciated and sometimes challenged, and where we look for the next generation of clinician investigators who can help move the field forward. So it's a very important interaction for us, and dare I say, marriage with yes. CMSC that has now been going on, I think this is the seventh year.
That's correct.
Has been one that's strengthened and has provided an increasing forum for us to interact, and particularly around this issue of young people. So the cooperative interaction around what used to be called the Whitaker Tract, I think, has been a major step forward. I certainly hope June agrees.
Oh, I totally agree. And the one thing that I think this forum has become is probably the largest meeting focusing only on MS in North America, if not, you know, potentially Latin America as well. And we're hoping to set a model for other organizations in Europe and throughout the world, because most of the other meetings are usually medically focused, and this meeting brings everybody together, the whole MS team, and it allows people such as nurses, physical therapists, occupational therapists, to learn from you, the scientists, and vice versa, you, the scientists, to interact with those of us on the front lines providing care. How does it benefit patients? Because I think as people go home reinvigorated and excited about new information, care will be benefited and care will be improved. And I think we're all kind of proud of being able to say we're one network, we're one family, we're one marriage in terms of MS. Yeah.
And the atmosphere in this meeting is a little bit different than some of the other
yes.
meetings that we go to.
They can tell. They've seen me at AAN. They've seen me at ECTRIMS. But here at Consortium, they can tell that
That's
there's
right.
a little bit of a different vibe. And really...
And we know this is the only place you'll get educated.
Yeah, you'll know that's home. And, you know, this vibe is very important, but also... Giving back and only by educating the next generation, are we going to have a future of people taking care of people with MS? So much this week we've talked about the team approach rule, what I call MSTAR,
right.
So the multiple sclerosis team approach rule. And I always focus on the patient as the center and the care partner and the family and the job. And I usually say we're in the background. But a meeting like this lets us be a little bit in the foreground, but not be in the foreground alone, just us medical doctors. It lets us be the whole group. So we have IOMSN here, we have the nurses, we have the physical therapists, nurse
That's
practitioners,
right.
PAs, occupational therapists, speech therapists, case managers, social workers. we really get the whole team really together. So I want to thank you guys so much for joining us, and thank you so much for putting on such an amazing meeting.
Well, we thank you for your dedication to MS, and keep up the good work.
Thanks a lot. Thank you, guys.
Thank
Enjoy the rest of it.
Yes, thank you.